For my next video, I'd like to do one on an app that's sometimes overlooked and not used as often as it should be, and it's called Samsung My Files. So obviously I'm running a Samsung S25 Ultra. This app works on all Samsung devices. It may be a little different because I'm on One UI 8 Beta 7, waiting for the exact unbeta release, the full version of it, which should be any day. And I doubt they'll make much changes to this, so I thought I'd make a video showing people this app. So here it is. It's at the very bottom, called My Files. So let's open that, and there'll be some things I don't want you to see, but most of the stuff is pretty well open book here to me. But this is a way, like it says, manage your storage. So if you don't know how to use this, just be careful on deleting things, because there's certain things you don't want to delete. But if you do, you can get them back in the trash, where it says trash, file sitting in the trash, and various apps. So you can go to your trash and then recover them by hitting the tab and then recovering them. Like, I don't know here, let's see, like a contact. Like any file, any trash app would normally work. So you'd go here, you'd hit select, and then you'd recover it. So at the bottom, I can hit restore or delete all. So that's handy in case you delete the wrong thing. But let's just kind of go over this from the top to bottom and kind of get into it a little bit. So it tells you right off the bat what you have. So it starts out with images, videos, audio files, docs, downloads, and installation files, APKs. And then you can also search. So you have a very powerful search. That's neat. That's new. Search inside files. So, for example, if you have a note and you want to search for something inside the Notes app, that's going to do that. So, pretty powerful ability. So, that's our search. Then, of course, we have clear recent lists and settings. But each one, self-explanatory. You tap on images, you're going to see all your image files. You tap on installation files, you'll see all your installation files, which I, of course, have none, etc. Recent files, you'll see all your newest and recent files, which comes in pretty handy if you, say, you download a file and you don't know where the heck it downloaded to. You can go into this and find it right there as a recent file. Then it's going to tell you your internal storage. So I have 127 gig of used of 512, and you can tap on that. And then this is where you want to be kind of careful on what you delete and what you don't delete. But this is the actual, like, the hard drive of your computer. It actually shows you where your files are located and what they are, stuff like that. Very handy. It'll also show you your Google Drive, which I think is nice because it integrates the Google Drive with your Samsung device. So it integrates it very, very well, that you can manipulate your files in your Google Drive and send them into your Samsung device and vice versa. Say you take a big video on your Samsung device and you don't want it sitting there eating up 5 gigs of storage, you can move it right to your Google Drive. Likewise, network storage. If you have network, you can move things to a storage device. And then trash and manage storage. This is nice. So if we want to free up space, which I'm not really concerned about space, that's why I always tell everybody, get a device with enough space. So you don't have to sit there always worrying about, oh, I'm out of space. So I don't have to really worry much. But if you did, this is how you would manage it. Like, I can go to videos, and then there's all my videos that I can delete or whatever I want to do. And it tells me the size, and then my documents, images, compressed files, etc., and all the different things I can manipulate. So duplicate files, got to be careful with that one. One time, I'll show you here. Let's see if I can find one. It also shows your Google Drive. Okay, there's Google Drive. I saw a whole bunch of files that were the same, and it's because I had some on internal and some on Google. So they actually split this up now, so that's neat. So this is my internal storage, all my files with internal, and then I don't have OneDrive. I do, but I'm not signed in. And then I have my Google Drive, so that separates them out, tells you how many duplicate files you have and the size that it's taking. Gives you suggestions. So for me, it says free up 3.6 gig of space by archiving 27 unused apps. Your personal data and settings will be saved. Clean 2.6 of storage by deleting downloaded files you haven't used. So it's really, really a very powerful file manager. So like I said, most people are fairly good with their file managers on their computer. Same concept with your file manager on your phone. You should always be up with it and know what's going on in the files that are on your phone and taking up space before they become overwhelming, and then you have to really do a lot of things. Let's get into some settings here. I'll just look to see if there's anything interesting. So Google Drive, log yourself in. So your Google Drive information will show up into this app. We can allow mobile data usage, show hidden file systems. If you're not sure of the hidden file systems and what they are, I would keep that turned off. So then that way you don't accidentally delete a hidden system file. Because if you do, you can lock up your phone. So it's kind of gets dangerous. Show cloud files and categories. That's self-explanatory. Edit menu layout, so I can change my menu layout just by dragging and dropping. I'll just keep it as stock. Permissions, that's obvious. Customization service on. Get help clearing space if your device starts running out of room while you're traveling. Activities, that's what we were going over before. It gives you some advice on what to delete and what you should do. And then of course about, which is common sense. So that's it. That's on my video for my files app made by Samsung for Samsung. I hope you found my video to be helpful. Thank you for being here. Please click like and subscribe to my channel. Leave me a comment down below. Thank you for your time. And until next time, I'm out.